Hi, you guys. Welcome to another First Impression Friday video. McCall's Fall came out, I don't know, sometime last week. So we are here to take a look at the new collection. I think, I'm pretty sure, correct me if I'm wrong, that this is the last of the Big Four's fall collection. So we'll have a few weeks of a break from Big Four releases. I'll be able to do a bunch of indie pattern companies, and then they'll start releasing their winter holiday. So, but let's take a look at this. So first up, we have what they're calling a top. And then here it says knit poncho tops. Are we still using the word poncho? Some of these terms, I don't know about. Shouldn't it be like cape or something? Anyways, poncho tops with wide sleeve bands and options for cropped, shaped, and tassel hems. How cute is that tassel hem? Turtleneck and crew neck options as well. Let's take a look at the photos. Super cute styling here. Still young and fresh, but also like ageless, you know, like anybody could wear this, the whole outfit. So this is one of the versions. I guess that's the turtleneck. It said something about cuff bands, right? So I guess that's what that is. And then you have a tassel hem, you have a split hem here. Real loose. Here is the line drawing. So you can kind of see how it comes together. You really just have like a rectangle of fabric that you sew some little knit bands onto. Cute. There's a turtleneck version. And then there she is again. Here's the back. Not much to discuss fitting wise here because obviously it's so loose fitting, but you do have the three different necklines. You have the like just crew or stitched neckline, and then one turtleneck. And wait, that can't be right. Didn't I say there were three necklines? Options for cropped, shaped, and tassel hems, turtleneck and crew neck options. Okay, so three hem options. I see. Cropped, scooped, or shaped, and then the tassel hem. Very cute. I wonder how short the cropped one is. And also maybe some styling ideas for that. I imagine it hits just above the like true hip line. Maybe, I don't know. But the tassels are really cute too. Let's look at the yardage and see how they have us doing those. Oh, you actually make the tassels. Wow, it's not purchased like, I don't know if I was thinking like curtain tassels that you would just sew on. They have you actually make the tassels. That's pretty fun, right? That's an interesting way to incorporate many different facets of the company that owns McCall's Patterns. Remember in the last video, they were linking out to like where you can buy these buttons. It was a little bit random, but this, it doesn't seem as random. That seems actually pretty cool and pretty fun. Like a fun little way to, I don't know, make your own trim. They also have those like tassel maker things if you wanted to do it that way, but they also, I guess, have this little hack too. Anyways, so moderate stretch knits, 35% across the, 35% stretch, sweater knits, French terry, sweatshirt fleece, cotton knit. Yeah, so you want, it's not a stable knit, but it's definitely not like a super lightweight, drapey, super stretchy ITY rayon knit. I mean, you could make it out of that, but I think that it would look, you know, it needs to be a little bit substantial and hefty to like hold all these folds and just the volume of it all. Fabric requirement wise, you really only, so it only is suitable for 60 inch fabrics or more. And it's anywhere from like 1.5 yards up to just about 2 for the cropped version, and then goes up to a little more than 2.5 for the longer version. So kind of a bit of a fabric hog, but with all this volume, to be expected. Cute. All right, next we have this little trench coat, Mrs. Jacket Coat and Belt. Double-breasted lined trench coat has storm flaps. Aren't they called gun flaps? Because that's where, like, the soldiers would rest their guns, and so you needed, like, extra protection there. What's a storm flap? Maybe they're interchangeable. pleated raglan sleeve and buckle belt. All right. Again, with the oversizedness of it all, still happening, Gen Z just absolutely loves, like, nothing fitting, like, close fitting at all. You've got this really nice notched collar with the buttonholes in it. I mean, this is like a substantial coat for McCall's. Here's a shorter version. Again, with the flaps, whether you call them storm flaps or gun flaps. You've got this little welt pocket with a flap. I think the sleeve might be a little bit flared too, which is kind of cute. Raglan sleeves, like they said. This flap here, maybe that's what the storm flap is. And the front one is called the gun flap. Look at this though. A buttoned vent. Lots of really, really, really interesting details here. I wish we could see the back of the short one. Okay, so the back of the short one does not have a vent at all. Also, the sleeve does not look very flared, but it does have two pieces, I think. Yeah, I mean, this is a pretty decent trench coat. Something you might expect to see, like, in a Vogue pattern. But here we are with McCall's. Cute. Again, a little bit hard to assess fit because it's just so oversized. Wool blends, gabardine, water repellent fabrics, and then you need some lining. And then notions, you really just need buttons and a buckle for your belt. And you don't even have to do the buckle because you can see they're not even buckling it. They're just tying it in a knot. So depending on how you would wear the belt, you may not even need the buckle. Yeah, taking a lot of fabric here, up to 5 yards for the longer version, in the biggest size. And then your lining, of course, would, you know, be similar to that. Also a ton of interfacing, again, because that's how well-made coats are made. You have your fashion fabric. It's usually the whole thing is interfaced, or at the very least, the entire facing would be interfaced. Maybe some area of the cuff, the belts, like all these different areas. So you need a ton of interfacing for it too. And we do get some bust line and hip line measurements. So it's pretty much, well, actually the hip line is a little bit narrower than the bust line. So it's kind of like an inverted trapezoid, is that right? What's the one that's like a pyramid with the top chopped off? 4 sides and 2 of them are at angles, whatever that one is. Because you can see pretty much through and through, the hip line is 1 inch narrower than the bust line. So very full, lots of volume at the bust line, and then it comes down to be, you know, kind of close fitting through the hip. So those of you that are, fuller chested, I think you would absolutely love this. It would look like $1 million on you, really highlight your small waist and hip. Ooh, puppy got excited. And then those of you that are apple shapes also, I think that this would, serve you well. Us pear shaped people, it depends on how you wear it. I can't imagine myself wearing it necessarily closed. At least not to be like the most flattering way, obviously to stay warm, but, I can imagine myself like tying the belt around my back and leaving the front open. So you do get a little bit of that waist shaping open at the hips. So you can kind of see that there's a body there. So it just depends on how you style it. This is a Melissa Watson, pattern. So you are going to get all of those fitting, tips, tissue fitting tips. That's the Palmer Plush like method. All right, now we're moving into this cutie little dress. Where else did we see the accented collars recently? Was that Butterick? Collared fit and flare dresses with cup sizes, bias cut skirt. Love that. Side seam invisible zipper. Love that. Long and short sleeves with gathered barrel cuff. Pointed and classic collars included. So I've talked about bias skirts before, but they just, when the fabric is cut on the bias, it just skims the body in such a beautiful way. It is very flattering on every single like body shape out there. It just hugs your curves in all the right places. I don't know how else to say it. Obviously your fabric, like if your fabric has stripes or any directional fabric at all, you will be able to tell that. So you need to find a print that's all over, to kind of minimize that, or find a print that really highlights that you really want to call attention to the stripes. The bodice itself, pretty simple. I think there are some princess seams here, a little keyhole with your collar detail, and then these are the sleeves with the barrel cuffs. There's the short sleeve version, really sweet, right? And then this has like kind of like a rounded collar. There's another version where the collar is the same as the self fabric, also really beautiful. Now this is a kind of high neck, long sleeve, you know, knee length or longer. So this is covering up a lot of your body. So just keep that in mind when you are picking your print. If you pick something that's like too bold, then it's just like this, you know, crazy print walking around because you can't see much of you, you know, other than just your little face and the lower half of your leg. All right, so obviously something happening here. Are those pleats in the shoulder? That's kind of interesting. I don't know if it's just too small through the waist here. I don't know exactly what's happening with that. But you can see, look how beautiful the skirt is. Just the skirt is amazing. This, I don't know. I didn't notice it so much in the front that it was too small, but I guess it is. So it's riding up just a little bit. All right, line drawings. And no, there are not pleats. So I'm not entirely sure what is happening there. Ironed poorly? I mean, I guess there are some here too. Yeah, this, I don't know if the front is causing the back to do this or the back is just poorly drafted. I don't know what is happening, but this is kind of a mess. And you don't normally see that on the backs. Normally you see all the issues on the front, but all right, there are line drawings. Cute dress though. Really cute dress. Maybe you just need to like size up in the waist. I don't know. Let's see if we get any finished measurements. Crepe, challis, cotton blends, and stable knits. Yeah, a like a ponte knit, like a lightweight ponte would be really nice, especially with that bias drape. Invisible zipper, hook and eye, two size ranges, and then your fabric requirements. Yeah, 2.5 yards. Ish, 3 yards for the longer one. And then you have the measurement at the bust line and hip line. So no waist measurement. I wonder if they used the wrong cup size on her. That might have caused the issue. It's hard. It's really hard to say. But 34.5 inches up to 52 inches at the bust line, depending on your cup size. And then hip line measurement, 42.5 up to 58. But it is kind of like an A-line skirt, so it is pretty roomy through the hip, design ease-wise. All right, now we've got this little number. Another cutie, Mrs. Tunic and Dress. This button-down shirt dress has a V-neck, drop shoulders, and ruching at waist. View options include sleeveless, long sleeves, and shirt tail hem. The sewing pattern comes in tunic and above knee dress length. This I actually really like, and I don't normally tend to go for like super fitted, but I do love ruching. I've always loved ruching. All these little like gathers work to like kind of camouflage what's happening underneath them. So for this, it would be the midsection. And because, again, voluminous at the bodice, so really roomy, lots of ease at the bust, and a little bit more fitted in the hip. So you can imagine for a pear shape in a dress like this, it would give the illusion of an hourglass because you would already be a little bit wider through here, and then this would, you know, make you look wider, and so it would be wide, skinny, wide. So here's the long sleeve version. It's a drop shoulder with a little sleeve sewn on, so not super complicated sleeve construction there. Just a little bit of funkiness with the button band, but you would check that for yourself, I'm assuming. There is the sleeveless version. And then that's the version she's wearing, right? I think that was the version she was wearing. Here's the back. The back has fisheye darts. I can't tell you the last time I've seen a kind of shifty dress without fisheye darts. I really feel like they've been adding them in a lot of these patterns, which makes me just so happy. So happy. She's wearing A, B, C. So these two are different. Oh, this must be the tunic length. Which I could really see being adorable in a like white crisp shirting. I think this, they use some kind of like either velvet or like micro whale corduroy, I'm not sure, but anything that you would make like a shirt dress out of, like denim would be really great, chambray obviously, you know, any of those, like faux suede would be super cool. Yeah, I think they might have just kind of pulled this in a little bit too tight through her midsection, which is why you're getting a little bit of gaping at that one button. So, you know, add a little bit of wearing ease in there and it will look perfect. Here is the yardage fabric, crepes, cotton blends, stable knits, and poplin. I don't know about crepe, but I can definitely see poplin, like shirt, a lot of shirtings are poplins. Cotton blends, obviously, stable knits, and like I said, any of those like fall fabrics. Even like a stretch sateen would be really good, give you a little bit of extra like comfort because it stretches a little bit. And then you just need your buttons, two size ranges, fabric requirements under 2 yards for the tunic length, and then goes up to just about 2.5 for the both of the dresses. The finished bust measurements are 35 to 50.5. Hip line measurements are 37 to 52.5. So again, fitted at the hip line, very roomy at the bust line. Okay, next up, whoa, hello, pretty. Can I wear that to Target? A knit keyhole cut out fit and flare dress has a pull-on style with back neck closure. Okay, that's a little bit contradictory, but okay. And half, three-quarter, and long sleeve options. All right, let's take a look. So we have a bodice. This one might be a little bit long. You can see how she's folding in on herself way up here. So maybe 1.5 inches or so long, but that could also be the skirt kind of pulling on this fabric a little bit and kind of pulling it down. But this is the 3/4 sleeve. It is a set-in sleeve. This does seem to be like way like falling off her shoulder, like almost like I bet she was pulling on it a lot, trying to keep it up or having to put some kind of like double-sided tape in there. I don't know if that's because this strap that inevitably goes through here and gets sewn in up here somewhere is just too long. I don't know. This seems weird to me how it's kind of falling off the shoulder like that. Like if you have a shoulder seam, that should be up on your shoulder. But nonetheless, this little, you know, wraparound doomahick is really pretty. I do like that a lot. And then you come down to the skirt. You've got a center front seam. It does seem like a side seam because her leg is sticking out, but I think they've just kind of like twisted the skirt around a little bit. Tons of volume in the skirt. This is probably some kind of jersey. It's really pretty. Yeah, you can see here the center front front seam. They also did a little bit of top stitching here too. Yeah, even the drawing, the opening here is narrower than on her. Oh, and then you can do color blocking. This, you have to be a little bit careful because you could end up in figure skater territory pretty easily. But yeah, that's really pretty. I can imagine it in all sorts of prints. Yeah, you can see here where her waistline is. So double check the length of the bodice for sure. But the back is really cool, how it's just kind of like a yoke. So that's fun. Pretty. I think they're going to do really well with this one. I think a lot of people will be buying that up. It's different, right? Like, we don't see that a lot. So they did say that it was, what did they say? Pull on with a back neck closure. So what I think that they mean by that, let's go back to the back. Oh, her hair's covering it. I think what they mean is you pull it on and then that like front strappy thing snaps onto the back or something. We can look at the yardage to see what the... So three hook and eyes they have you doing. They also have you finish the neckline with some elastic, which is really, really great finishing detail. I did that on the dress that has the sew along for knits for beginners. I did it in like that blue fabric with the yellow flowers. That has elastic in the neckline, and it's one of my favorite, most comfortable dresses. It doesn't ever gape. It stays nice and close to the body. I love using elastic in that way. All right, so 50% stretch. That's kind of a lot. Interlock, cotton knit, velvet, and jerseys. So I think, ITY and rayon might be higher percentage stretch, like 75 or 100. But you can definitely find some that are like a little bit more stable. Usually if like they're thicker, they're a little more stable. So, but yeah, that 50% stretch is important. I don't think you could do it out of anything with less stress, less stretch, but you could go more probably and be fine. Okay, so two size ranges. Dress A, which is like the one with the color blocking, is here. And then dress C, the one she's wearing, has almost like a little more than 4.5 yards of fabric. So again, you're going to have to find something that's probably on sale. Otherwise, you're going to spend like $1 million on this dress, which actually would be worth it because it is really pretty and fun and interesting, and people would not believe that you made it. All right, moving on away from dresses now. We've got this skirt. This whole style right now is such a hot trend. I mean, it's very much Pretty Woman. I see a lot of Pretty Woman in this. I see a lot of Troop Beverly Hills before they go out into the wilderness. The big oversized cable knit sweater, the huge belt with the huge buckle, this like Western style skirt with the boots. It's like a whole thing. So right on trend with this. Kudos for that. But we're analyzing the skirt. It's not really much to see from here other than you know we've got these pleats in it. Okay, so this one is, that looks a little bit more like a schoolgirl situation to me, but you have the, not a lapped zipper. What's it called? When the seam allowances fold over and meet in the middle. Oh, I can't remember. But you have that, whatever that's called, zipper on the side. Nice deep waistband, a bunch of pleats, and then this one has some kind of trim going through the front. This, I think, is the version she made, maybe, or the one she's wearing. Yeah, I mean, there's not a lot to it. There's just one skirt, three lengths, and this one has some trim on it. It's just a pleated skirt. So, you if you just look at the line drawings and then go to your stash, if you've been collecting patterns for a minute, you probably have some kind of pleated skirt like this in there. Just looking at the line drawings and not the fabrication or anything like that, I bet you have something like this. So it doesn't even have like a pocket or anything. It's just very plain. So there's that. Cotton blends, gabardines, crepes, and sateen. So I do think that this depends on the view you're making. Hers is probably a crepe. It could be some kind of like rayon poplin, maybe even a challis. This, though, I do think is the heavier weight sateen or cotton blends. I think these two you could probably make out of the more stable fabrics. If you start to make one like this this length and volume out of the stable fabrics, like not drapey fabrics, you run the risk of it just being very much like a tent, and sticking out away from your body where you want it to kind of be a little bit closer. Shorter lengths, that's okay. The longer it gets, though, it's, you know, a little bit tent-like. All right, so zipper and then optional ribbon. I'm trying to think of, like, a way that you could make that, like, I don't know if the ribbon was, like, an afterthought or if they saw something somewhere where people were, like, in ready-to-wear, where people were doing that and it looked cool. This doesn't feel, like, cool to me. I don't know anybody that would be like, yes, I definitely want a mini pleated skirt with a ribbon trim. But maybe if I saw it made up, I would feel differently. Fabric requirements are not much. The mini skirt is 1.5, 1.75 for the knee length, and 2.25 for the full length. And then some interfacing for your waistband. And that's it. This is like, I'm surprised this is not like a learn to sew pattern. That's how easy this one is. All right, now we have this little play suit, romper, jumpsuit, robe, and sash. Oh my God, is this pajamas? Pajama romper. I made a pajama romper. I've made two of them. I actually love them. This romper and jumpsuit are V-neck, wide leg, pull-on. Robe has wide front bands, long sleeves, and closes with sash. For this loungewear set, use knit fabrics. Yeah, I mean, they're totally, like, getting the Kim Kardashian Skims brand. She does all this, like, matchy knitwear, loungewear type of stuff. And uses a whole bunch of different fabrics for it. She does have a rib knit line. I think she has something made from like shearling or sherpa. So if you could find like a lightweight one of those, that would be really cool. Lots of really like French terry, of course, would be awesome. But this rib knit is beautiful. Beautiful. And rib knit isn't super expensive. So that's good because you probably need a lot of fabric for this. But robe, jumpsuit, knit. I mean, how cute is that? How comfortable must that be? And I know they're selling it as a loungewear set, but, like, maybe. You put on a denim jacket over that? Come on now. It wouldn't be that bad. And then there's the robe picture. All right, here she is in her jumpsuit without anything covering it up. I love that they posted this because you can really see lengthwise. We've talked about that before in some of my fit videos. How this fits. So you can see how deep the V is. It pretty much is in line with her full bust here, but the arm size is not super, super low. So it looks like this whole, all the length through here is good. And then you go through to the crotch line. And I imagine that her crotch line is somewhere around here. So it might be a little bit long for her, but also, you know, you need that like wearing ease and you need to be able to sit down in it. And of course, like, you know, she's raising her arm over her head pretty much. So you need to have a little bit of extra room there. And then you've got this beautiful leg line, beautifully finished. This is really cute. And then, just like I was saying, she threw on her pajamas and went out the door in her pajama robe. There's the back. Oh, good. Here's the back of the jumpsuit. Yeah, the crotch line looks really good to me. Beautiful V in the back as well. Sits on the shoulder nice. This one looks really good, you guys. This inner inseam is right where it should be in the middle of the leg. Yeah, I'm not seeing a lot that's jumping out at me about this. So you get in and out of it because the V-necks are so wide. Did they make her a matching scrunchie? No, but they should have. Cute. That one is also going to do really, really well for them, I think. So cute. So, so, so cute. I really, really like that one. All right, yardage-wise, let's see how much it would take to make this. So 35% cross grain knit fabric. So rib knit, cotton knit, French terry, and lightweight sweater knits. Again, go look at the Skims loungewear. You'll get a lot of inspiration for fabrics. She uses stuff that you wouldn't normally think about as loungewear, but then when they put it all together, you're like, yeah, that does look really comfortable. And then you just need a little bit of 1/4 inch elastic for the romper and the jumpsuit. I'm hoping that that is also for the neckline again, because again, that I love that detail. All the sizes are in one, hallelujah. So you can grade from, you know, medium to 2X if you need to, which is probably what I would need to do. Or just make a whole bunch of them for everybody in your family and you'd have everybody's size in one. So 2 1/4 yards for the romper. The jumpsuit, 3 5/8 yards. Now that is quite a fabric hog. Your robe is 3.5. And then you need a bunch of fusible interfacing for the robe and sash. I'm imagining that's for like the front placket, maybe for the belt. So finished bust measurement for the rompers, close fitting, probably a little bit of negative ease there too, because we're working with kind of stretchy knits, but 31.5 up to 49. So yeah, I would fall in the medium category there. And then the measurement at the hip line, I would fall into, well, maybe an extra large and then take smaller seam allowances. So I would definitely have to grade up two sizes through the waist. So it's good that they're all in one because the medium is usually in the smaller size range and, you know, that's what it's just like to be in between. And then they gave the finished measurements for the robe, but really, guys, I mean, it's just like an open front cardigan type of thing. So obviously lots of ease and all that kind of stuff. This width here for the romper is nice because you can get like a thigh measurement without actually having to, you know, measure it yourself manually. This one's good. Love this one. Okay, now we have this little number. Do we get the leggings too? Yeah, top and leggings. So this tee and hoodie has a drop shoulder and asymmetric seams, perfect for color blocking and print mixing. Yes, I agree. Hoodie has long sleeves with banded hem. Tee has high-low hem. Leggings have crossover V-waistband. Do you guys remember when I was talking about that? When I did, oh God, the leggings in January maybe for Sew Together 21, I was giving like hacks and inspiration for the leggings, and I talked about how everyone was doing the crossover. Anyways, all right, so just your regular old grown-on sleeve t-shirt. Nothing special there, but they did do this little color blocking thing. There's the little V. Everybody and their brother last fall and winter were buying up leggings that had this little detail here. I mean, very expensive leggings were all sold out because of this little V detail. And somebody somewhere had a tutorial. If you go back to my leggings video, I think it'll talk about it, or at least the Sew Together 21 video. Anyways, if you can't find it, just let me know. But yeah, somebody somewhere had a hack for how to do it. Not difficult. And then, okay, so then there's your hoodie with the little muted colors, very on trend. This looks a little, I mean, it was supposed to be a legging, so it's either too big through the knee or too tight through the calf, one of the two. I don't think you should be seeing any wrinkles on a legging. It should be negative ease everywhere. So a little something funky there. All right. And then there we have it. T with a scoot back. There's your hoodie and your legging. Now they made their hoodie out of like some kind of jersey or something, but I could totally see it out of much, much thicker, fabric. Oh, I see why. Because the legging. So they're going to tell you 75% four-way stretch knits, athletic knits for the legging. And then if you want it to coordinate, obviously you would use the same exact fabric somewhere in the hoodie. So then the rest of the fabrics would have to be that same weight. What I'll say though is that if you buy like, let's say black or something in color that's like super easy to find in lots of different fabrics, you can still make the legging out of an athletic knit, but then you could do this hoodie out of like sherpa or sweater knit or something a little bit more thicker and a little bit more substantial, and they would still like go together. So just think about it that way, because I don't know, I don't love like a little droopy, saggy hood. You know, like especially this picture where it just is like meh. It also like the point of a hood is to keep you warm, right? Like I can't imagine, does this really keep you that warm? I don't know. But anyway, something to think about with the fabric. So this is a Mrs. and Women's. Yeah. So we've got three different size ranges here. And the top goes, gosh, that top. Oh, but the contrast too. So you've got this amount plus 3/4 of a yard plus up to 7/8 of a yard. So it could be as much as 2-3 yards of fabric for just for the top, depending on your size and contrasty stuff. If you don't do the contrast, it's half that. And then what is happening here? Oh, wait, just kidding. If you don't do, oh, you have to do the contrast? You don't have to do the contrast. But here's the other one. This must be contrast. Well, I don't know what is happening. Top B. So this must be the hoodie. And then here's your leggings. That's complicated to look at. And then centimeters. That's all we have. All right. So there's that. If I'm gonna make either one of the two loungewear ones, it's gonna be the jumpsuit one. Okay, now we've got a Mrs. Top. Oh my. My. There's a lot that went wrong here. Okay. Drop shoulder wrap top with attached wide wraparound sash has several design options, including a shawl collar, bell sleeve, and long sleeve. This is gonna just come down to fabric choice. I don't know if they just had some of this laying around. I just can't really see. Yeah. I don't know what else to say. So let's ignore the fabric, right? So we've got this little crossover here with gathers under the bust, but they seem a little bit like off to the side too much. Like the fullness of her bust is through here, so I feel like that's where the gather should be. And then you have this attached sash that wraps around your body and ties in the back. So it creates this little like droopy thing. And then I don't know what they were thinking with these pants. Like, I don't even really understand the pants at all. Bell sleeve. And then there is the shawl collar. This also looks like it's supposed to come down like past your belly button. Obviously, it didn't on her. Like, these line drawings look great. Like, if. Yeah, what is this? I mean, what are they doing to her? This poor girl. Like, no clothes should fit like this. I know that this is not what they're selling. Like, they're just trying to sell the top, but come on now. Come on now. Get this girl some pants. And it's too bad too, because I really do think that that top would look great if so many other things were different. Like, I love the little back ruffles in the back. I really like the sash. I just think that there's just nobody's gonna be able to see past that. Look how cute the line drawings are. Darn. All right. Yardage. Crepe, cotton blends, poplin, and charmeuse. I totally agree. Single fold bias tape for A, which I think was the sleeveless one. So you would just use that to finish off the open arms. Let's see. Yardage wise, up to 2 3/4, depending on your size. All the sizes are in one, so you could blend really easily if you need to. And then, yeah, 2 3/4, no matter what the version is. Bust line measurement, super close fitting bust. So you got 33 and a half up to 51. And then I guess the waist is technically adjustable because you've got the sash. Like, I feel like this line here, this underbust line, is what's sewn in. And then the rest of it you can kind of futz with a little bit if you need a little bit of extra roomsies. All right, now we've got a top, a polo knit pullover. How chic. Have half placket opening with collar and long sleeves. Beautifully sewn. This sewing pattern includes view options for banded hems, stitched hems, open placket, and buttoned placket. Again, I love how they styled this with this little, like, neck tie. I was just trying to see how it was constructed. Whatever fabric this is similar to what you could make that loungewear out of. But you've got your collar. There's no collar stand. And I think that these edges might be raw, I think. I can't zoom in anymore to be able to tell, but I think they might be raw, which, listen, that's like 1,000 times easier, so I'm here for that. Perfect length, nice looking arm, and I mean, look at how well sewn and pressed and everything that is. Really good job. Then there's the button one, so this would be made out of like a jersey or something. This one has the banded waist, which I'm not a huge fan of. I don't need any more volume here than I already have naturally, if you know what I'm saying. Yeah, super cute, super chic little jean with a loafer and then just the little necktie. So cute. I don't know what they were trying to pull off here, tucking this up. Like, I see that you tucked that. So maybe this sleeve is a little bit long. What did they do over here? Is this, I don't think this is supposed to be a grown on sleeve either. So maybe the shoulder line is a little bit long. Yeah, I don't know. Maybe it is supposed to hang off the sleeve a little bit. I think they're going for like a relaxed fit. So I think it should be somewhere in between. I think hers is a little bit long, but being like up on the shoulder would be too short too. So you just got to kind of, you know, measure yourself. But yeah, cute, simple little basic pattern that honestly, like, I'm not sure that I have anything like that. It isn't a basic with a twist, though. It is just a basic. But the way they styled it gives it that twist that I like, I guess. All right, moderate stretch knits. So, lightweight sweater knits, cotton knit, interlock, and velour. This must be some kind of sweater knit. Four buttons, and then they broke up the size range on this one, which just kills me. So, extra small to medium, and then large to 2X. And then you would need 2 yards, just about two. So just around 2 yards. Your finished bust measurements are 33 and a half up to 51. And then this lower edge width kind of acts as a hip measurement. It's not, let's look at this one. It's not as, like, your hip measurement is way down here. So you actually want to measure yourself at your high hip. And then that's what you would compare for this lower edge width. So 38 inches to 55 and a half. And I can be like 2 inches narrower just by going from low hip to high hip. Like, that's how dramatic my hip shape is. So it does make a difference for those of us that are curvy. All right. Cute. All right. Now we've got this little top. Knit V-neck button-down sweater cardigan comes with multiple length options, sleeves, and optional scalloped lace trim details. Puff sleeves, love, and long sleeves are also in this pack. Pack, really? The lengths included are cropped hip and mid-thigh. Use decorative buttons for a retro look. Okay, so this one definitely has like a vintage vibe, which isn't 100% my thing, especially with this lace collar. Although I did sew that lace collar white shirt, that like crisp white shirt, this feels a little bit grandma to me. So but so and but if you we're removing that and we're looking at this just as it is, then it's a really, it's one of those, I don't know, I'm just really into like the sweaters with the sleeve detail right now. And although this is like a super basic cardigan, the sleeve is just giving me so much to go on. Then you have this version that doesn't have a puff sleeve at all. This is just like a regular cardigan with a knit band. No big deal. And then here is the mid-thigh version, kind of like a mini dress slash tunic, which you could easily just keep lengthening depending on how long you wanted it to be. I mean, she looks cool, you know, like, but if I went out in this, my friends would wonder what had happened to me. Yeah. It's just not my style. And that's okay. Oh no, you can see the control top. Come on now. Come on now. Wasn't this the same girl as with the bad pants before? Was it? All right. Yeah, fabric choice on this is everything. Let's see what they recommend. Oh, look, the line drawings we didn't see. Look how much better, right? I think it's the combination of the chunky sweater knit plus that particular lace that they used that I'm just, that's just not jiving with me. Also that it's contrasting color, you know what I mean? So maybe, I don't know, maybe I could be open to this done differently. All right, so 35% moderate stretch knit, sweater knits, rib knit, cotton blends, and velour. Man, they're really trying to push some velour, huh? Three buttons, scalloped lace, and then more buttons. All the sizes in one. 1.5 to 2 yards-ish. Lots of interfacing for that band where your buttons go. You could also do it without the buttons and just leave it, have it be like an open front cardigan, but you couldn't wear it like a top, which is essentially what she's done here. Okay. Measurement at bust line. Yeah, pretty roomy. 33 inches up to 50.5. And then your hip line measurement for the cardigan, which I guess is the pink one. Yeah, this hip line measurement, 35.5 up to 53. So it's not close. It's like semi fitted. All right. I could be convinced for this one. All right, now we've got a unisex pattern, which honestly, these are so great for the fall because like the holidays are coming up. You could literally just knock out an outfit for every single person you know. Unisex sweatshirt are draw shoulder long sleeve tops with contrast for color blocking. Cuffed jogger pants have elastic waistband with side pockets and banded hems. Hoodie has kangaroo pocket. Okay, didn't we just see this? First of all, didn't we just see this in Simplicity's fall? Which is fine, like, they're the same company, but they're not. Okay. But also, haven't we seen this 1,000 times, too? Like, this is nothing new. Come on, give us some unisex that's, like, not sweat suits. But, I mean, it is cute. I do kind of like the contrast thing. Fine. Oh. Yeah. I mean, just nothing really exceptional here. Okay. We're just going to look at the yardage really quickly. Sweatshirt, fleece, fleece, minky, French terry. Yeah, I think Sherpa would work too. They do have two sizes here, which is annoying, but small to large and then extra large to 3X. So the 3X is going to take your hip line up to 62 inches. No word on the bust line. And then here's all your fabric requirements. All the contrasting, you have to add it all up again. So, all right, now we have, like, why is this at the end? Why wasn't this with the other ones? Mrs. and Women's flight suit, basically. They're calling it a romper, a jumpsuit, and a belt, but it's basically a flight suit. Collared buttoned coverall romper and jumpsuit with back pleat, utility romper. How many names are we going to come up with for this? And jumpsuits have drop shoulders with long sleeves and cuffs. Also includes a sleeveless view with a rolled up band, side and patch pockets. Includes belt with D-rings. Yeah, I don't know. Are we still doing the flight suit thing? I know it was real big last fall. Is it sticking around? And I think that this is their women's model. So she is in the quote unquote plus size category. So we can see, like, on a body with curves, what's happening here. She has her defined waist, and then she has a belly protrusion. Amen, sister. Me too. So these feel low. Like, imagine if they were up here, right? And it didn't cause this much of a shaping situation. Right? Don't you think that would be a little bit more flattering? They just feel like they're almost at her knee. So they feel a little bit low to me. Other than that, though, like, the crotch line looks pretty good. You know, really hard to tell what's happening through here because of the belt. But drop shoulder, also, again, kind of hard to tell. The sleeve length looks good. Pant leg length looks intentional. There it is with the rolled sleeve. That's really cute. Oh, my gosh. Please look at the little romper version. Back looks. Let's look at the back. The pockets are always going to be an issue for me because they're so individual. Like, these pockets need to be a lot more toward the center and much higher. Like, much higher. They need to be over here somewhere. They are just, like, her butt is not even near there. It's, like, way over here. I never put my pockets on until after pretty much the whole garment is made and I can try it on my own body and then put it on my butt myself. And then you have your little pleat, which is nice. Nice little detail for utility suit, play suit, flight suit, with all the words, coverall. You do also, I saw it, but didn't think to say anything, but you do have your sleeve with the real placket, like a real working real placket. And you know that because of the sleeve seam here. I love the shorts version. Like, I love it a lot. Like, these are okay. They feel a little bit like been there, done that. But something about this, I don't know. This romper is just giving me life right now. It's very similar to the jumpsuit that I just posted with, like, the same button placket, no waist seam, all that. But this one has the real sleeve and the collar. So it is a little bit different. Twill, denim, cotton blends, corduroy. Yeah. I can even see the shorts, like the romper version, in like a faux leather. Oh, how cool would that be? Okay, misses and women's, A, B, and C. I don't know why they wrote that. 12, so a bunch of buttons and then a D ring. Three different size ranges. And then fabric requirements go up to, depending on the length of the version you're making and also the sleeve, it can be as much as 4 yards. So another kind of fabric hog. Bust line measurements are going to be pretty roomy, but the hip line measurements are kind of roomy too. Yeah, because I normally make a 20 in the hip, and that would give me like a bunch, I don't know. Maybe it's like another one of those like semi-fitted situations. Fitted, but not oversized, whereas the bodice is soups oversized. People still saying soups? Okay, I think we're rounding out the end here. We've got some crafts. We've got a little bag, a little hat and sleeve cuff, some aprons, kids' clothes, some kind of grocery bag. So, fun little craft stuff and costumes, which we do not review in the first impression video, just because I don't know what I'm looking at. I don't know what I'm talking about. Although I'll tell you that this girl's crotch is way too low. In the blue, not so bad, way too low. Okay. So yeah, that is it. That is, let's go to the lookbook. That is McCall's Fall. What did you guys think? I actually quite enjoyed it. I thought that it was a good collection that appeals to the younger demographic that McCall's is clearly calling out to, but also those of us that are just young at heart. Like, I could see lots of different ages, lots of different sizes, lots of different lifestyles wearing these patterns. This, I cannot forget this soon enough. Like, this needs to, Men in Black, be zapped from my mind. But some really good ones like this knit dress, the cape poncho thing, this even for a basic. Again, I could be convinced into this. They did really well with the knits, the loungewear, luxe loungewear for sure. A really, really exceptional jacket or coat. So, a lot of good things happening here. Do we like that bag? I think I do. It's a little cottage core, weird. Have my, well, my initials L, and L always just looks so boring. I guess I could do it in a script. Anyways, I'm just babbling at this point. And these are all the costumes. Okay. Wow. Costume lookbook. Oh, and then they threw in that skirt way back here. So yeah, I do think they'll do really well with this collection. It feels appropriate for the time in terms of like what people are doing. There's nothing super fancy about it, but there are those kind of outfits that just in case something comes up, you're ready to go, like this one. So that's what I think, but what do you think? Leave a comment in the comment section below this video. Let me know your thoughts on McCall's Fall. But that is going to do it for me today, y'all. Thank you so much for watching, and I will see you all very soon. Bye.